Indian nationals and foreign nationals, welcome to India. This is the world of drones. Let me try to take a drone journey of our poultry sector. I mean, drone journey means I'll be showing tits and pieces of all the sector happening in India right now. May I have the first slide? See, as you know that the numbers here really gives a great pleasure in putting it. 1 crore chicks per day, 26 crore eggs per day, $17 billion industry, 6 million people are employed, and now it is changing not more in southern India. This picture always reminds me the sector has changed so transformationally from a small chick to a colorful bird of this size, and now come to transition. I think none other than this slide will explain transition. Transition requires disruption, transition requires innovation, transition requires risk-taking to a new horizons. That is happening in industry right now. As you all know that, we have seen transition happening in our own visual things like from, you know, ambassador card to Ola's, SMS to WhatsApps, none other than card to Flipkart, and then basket to Big Basket. These are the things which have happened, and you know that our raw materials in the sector are, yeah, just a little bit numbers about the world scenario. Now you see here, Brazil is exporting 4.1 million metric tons. The import is Japan. Whereas India, we are yet to export any big content there. I think little jumble of that. Anyway, coming back to the transition, as I said you, none other than this example will quote you a better way of understanding that from the currency to now, we're going for a plastic economy. And this I already mentioned, this I mentioned. I think now you see the broiler numbers. Interesting about Brazil. Brazil, when I spoke in 2012, 7 million metric ton. Today it is producing 13.6 and 9.49 is only consumption. What is the transition? They are now everywhere in the world with almost 4.1 million metric tons of exports. China, India, this is the latest data. This is the picture of Brazil. See Sadia everywhere in the world. I think people across the globes know that Sadia is a company where it is doing so wonderfully that, you know, they are exporting. And egg numbers, China, mammoth, you can see, you know, 496.75. India, we are right now around 83. This is the data of USDA, which is 2013. And this is the picture to show China. And this is what the picture of India. So we have been, you know, located more in the southern India, the poultry sector, moving across, now going to central India, eastern part of the India, and other sectors also. And who are the drivers of our sector? Agriculture drives poultry. Agriculture drives poultry. Please note that I make a statement, when you want to watch poultry, start watching monsoon. Because the soya and the maize, if monsoon doesn't happen, Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka and Bihar, we are not a loss. What are the business models here? Majority are family run. The biggest Venkateshwara Group, 10,000 crore turnover, family run. Suguna, 7,000 crores, family run. Godrej, like that it runs. You can see a role of facilitation from government. Other than that, you have seen certain MNCs like Japfa, CP, Godrej in the field. What are the value chains? We are very good in back end. We are very good in core. We are now progressing for a transition in processing. That is the future. Let me put you in perspective. What are the transitions which are happening in our buying habits? You know that corn and soya is very critical. You know that how do we leverage the cost management to make poultry efficient? Our people are changed in buying behavior, storage, processing. And last one is very smart. There is one guy called Prakash Shetty in Mangalore. He always goes with hedging and trading. He knows that what is the future price of January of corn. He knows that what is the future price of soya in February. They block it. They block it. They know that hedging and trading is the order of the day. Today people have gone this. NCDX trends have become very common. People are watching them in their mobiles. This is a prediction for January. You can see maize goes on rising. Soya goes on dwindling down. This is the prediction of latest of last week. Storage has gone for a transformational change. No more feed mills. Silo is the order of the day. You have to have silos, smallest from 5 metric ton to the largest of Sri Ramireddy, 15,000 metric ton. You can see these are the pictures of feed mill of India. Biggest diameter silos. People are changing. People are going for a transition, coming for hatcheries. What are the innovation? Innovation is simple, single stage systems. We want quality. We want cost effective production. Automations are coming in every sector, feeding, watering, hatching, nest box. And people are monitoring in hatchery live. Egg speaks to the machine. Machine speaks to your mobile. Through your smartphone, you can track your machine wherever in India. And in vivo vaccinations. Vaccinations are done within the hatchery. Need not a chick to come out the vaccination. People are doing vaccination in vivo. And latest trend is broiler sexing. Because we have a huge, huge productions happening. I need 500,000 broiler chicks. I want to separate them. People are doing broiler sexing. Male chicks are separately reared. Female chicks are separately reared. Another interesting aspect is hatchery feeding. People are feeding at the hatchery itself. Within the 4 hours of window to catch that villi, we want to make hatchery feeding itself as a practice. This picture shows what is the hygiene we maintain our storage in hatchery. This picture shows single stage incubation. You want 1 lakh chicks a day, 10 lakh chicks a day people can give. This is a beautiful picture you can notice. Probably I think many of you would have not seen. These new boxes are coming in the hatchery. These chicks, when they come out from the eggs, they start feeding there itself in the hatchery. The feed and the water. Why? Because you will have a better villi understanding. And this is the chick sexing. Feather sexing can be practiced in broilers if you have a particular lines so that you can pick up male and females by feather sexing. Coming into farming concepts, people are changing. People want to have cost management as a principle. I want a better housing. I want a better automation of feeding and watering. Auto nesting is being done because labor is a great challenge in India too. This is a simple picture of a broiler farm. Today in Bangalore, we teach broiler farming, no construction. Please don't construct. Use stone, use GI pipes so that it can be a plug and play model. Don't put even 1 bag of cement. It becomes a gold farm. So that your investment appreciates, not depreciates. Stone appreciates, iron appreciates. Things are becoming economical for the future. This is a layer farm. The biggest layer farm is almost 3 million. I think common is 1 million in Andhra. These are the broiler breeding farms. Common is 30,000 capacity. You can find 1 lakh also. These are the slat system of broiler breeders, which we come in India. And this is an automated, environmentally controlled broiler housing. Farm to fork, no touch. No one should touch because you are in the modern era of hygiene, FSSAI standards, you will have to produce chicken without any touch. This is the future. Automated layer farm, integrated automation systems. You can monitor through your mobiles. This is the farm in Mysore in Karnataka. One simple gentleman, an engineer migrated from Chennai, has put up a farm of 40,000 in one shed, one single gentleman handling, totally packed up. He is now importing 80 lakh worth of equipment from Japan for auto packing and putting in branding for export. This is the egg collection systems. These are the breeding houses with automation. You can see the auto nesting happening. They say breakage is reduced, cleanliness is good, very good quality of hatching. No human touch there. This is the fort. I belong to Chitradurga, where we have a 7-level fort. Mr. Hegre has developed a 2-fort system of biosecurity. You can see the biosecurity has gone to a next level. You want another gate. I don't want lorry to come even near to the gate. The lorry is stopped well before the first gate so that an access is given to them. This is the sort of biosecurity we are putting in our Indian nation. Coming into our own best practice of government, rural transition. My God, what a transformation here. It's a great livelihood opportunity. We have seen from top to bottom, from Leh Ladakh to Kanyakumari, from Sikkim to Gujarat, it is becoming a great livelihood opportunity. And we are diversifying. And I'll tell you a story of branding. One gentleman has done wonderful effort. This is a great picture of Orissa. I'll tell you a simple story. They were earning 25 rupees, just giving 25 hens. Which are ready to lay 20 eggs tomorrow, put 5 rupees, 100 rupees in our pocket. This is the story we want to multiply. This is the diversification we are happening. Ducks, turkeys, quails, These are becoming delicacy. They are becoming, you know, value addition product. This is our farm. We have done automation for even for the country chicken. We have done automation, nobody goes in. Since 3 years we are working in, only one for egg collection we are going in. We have got such an efficiency now, 15 gram feed reduction, 20% high production. And this is another story. One gentleman, textile engineer, Mr. Manjunath, he started a branding called Happy End Farm, Free Range Farm. This was my dream. We are spending 30 rupees, 40 rupees for chocolates, Kinder Joy, biscuits. When can we put 30 rupees for our egg? As Linda told, egg is great magical figure. This is, he has proved it. He is selling 150 rupees for a six of box of one. He is selling in Spencer's, he is selling in Godrej. I think nobody can imagine that such a step has come in India. Processing, are we ready? Definitely, India is calling. India is in a great transition mode for a big growth. You'll find, you know, now Mr. Ashok Kumar of Karnataka, the president, he is a data man. Comes with lot of data analysis. People are predicting what is going to happen tomorrow to an extent possible. So these are the things which are happening, like most accurate data. We want to have supply demand analysis, faster price discovery. We are facing helpless situation. I think yesterday I read about Ranjit Reddy's press clipping. 70% of the broiler demand has reduced, 40% of the egg demand has reduced because of the sudden helpless situation which we are facing, which will come out. So this is the predictions in the chart. Wonderful big prediction chart by Ashok Kumar. He has given in 52 weeks, there are few green weeks, there are a lot of black weeks, which are Kartika, Navratri, Ganesha, Shravana, Lent, what not. So this is the situation a broiler industry or a layer farmer is facing in our country. Interesting clipping of a press. This is the press clipping of a company called Licious in Bangalore. They have told that they have segmented Bangalore in such an extent that only 60% is consumption in Bangalore East, 34% in Bangalore South, West 45%, 1.5% in Bangalore North. You can see only 0.74% opt for free-range chicken. So this is the requirement in each city, each layout, each town to segment it. Then you can focus it. This is what the great picture you must have seen in newspapers. India all over red because of the protein requirement. We are ready to become red because of the requirement which we have done, which we have adapted thanks to animal husbandry sector, where it is offering so much of non-vegetarian protein. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Food business is always a good business. Please enter. And this is one company, Licious. A young gentleman migrated from Jammu Kashmir. He's a bulleteer. He has lost his legs. Young fellow. Came to Bangalore. Set up a Licious company. First online marketing meat company of India. Funded by none other than Infosys Mohandas Pai, a venture capitalist. You can see the packaging. And he's doing online now like Ola. And this is the Grofers company's advertisement. The demarcation between non-vegetarian and vegetarian is going out. You'll see vegetables along with the meat. Because we need protein, we need fiber. And these are the chicken processing plants in India. We have right now 10 big processing plants. One plant producing almost 1 lakh per day. The second plant 40,000, third plant 40,000. We are processing almost 5 lakhs chicken per day in India. And these are the products we have ready to eat and ready to cook. Egg port plant, very good opportunity. We have a classical 3 plants, total put together almost 25 lakhs in one plant, 5 lakhs in one plant, and 10 lakhs in one plant. And this is a statement none other than the CEO of that company. We want to break 25 lakh eggs a day and produce 10,000 tons of egg powder annually. We hope to reach revenues of 500 crores by 2020. Young gentleman Shivakumar from SKM. And these are the chicken stores, which are nothing but protein stores. I would like to name them as protein stores. These are the protein stores for you. And this is the beautiful picture of shops, where you'll find a mixture of mobile shop and a darshini. So classical. You all see the mobile shops. They look so clean, so neat. This is the future requirement to be born in. And this company from Thailand, they came back in India 2013, started 12 outlets in Bangalore. Today they are having more than 600 outlets in the country. Korean Fokan, their investment now is more than $1 billion. the fast catching up in India. Simple recipe, 100 rupees is the ticket value, so that, you know, two recipes can be bought out. These are the different portions which are available. Now I told you in a drone journey what is present. So let me take you to the ladder to show you future in Indian context and Indian perspective. We have want to coin a word called green poultry, where you can have a poultry production in such a way that everything green, in a perspective of energy, economics and everything. First one is solar. Second one we want to harp on is water harvesting, solid and liquid waste handling and litter power. Beautiful east-west direction is available in our entire poultry farms. Please install. So now the production of 1 megawatt has come down to 5 to 6 crores. That means 100 kilowatt will be something like 60 to 70 lakhs. If you want to invest, that will be sufficient for a poultry farm of 30,000 or 50,000 capacity. And this is a litter power in Minnesota, 100 megawatt. Fiber tech company has put in. We need to think on these lines for our poultry sector to go for a poultry litter power project. This is a picture in Russia. And this is a picture of one of our entrepreneur, Mr. Kishore Hegde, who has done a solar system in Chikmagalur. And another thing is, please catch every drop which falls. Every drop is precious. Where you can store? Only Mother Earth. Only Mother Earth. Renovate your bore wells, tube wells, change your bore wells, change the first casing, see that, you know, you can store more water, whatever drops out from your surface area. And coming into the last segment, please beware of this bomb. Chicken waste bomb on the road. What is this? You'll find, you know, every shop owner is so proud of his shop being cleaned, but he takes up in a pack of like this, throws after about, you know, 1 kilometer or 2 kilometer, watching this side, that side, he throws off on the road and rushes up. He thinks that his shop is clean with deodorant. But now there is a solution, as Reddy sir was telling. What is the solution? Success story in Chennai. One Karnataka gentleman has migrated to Chennai. He is processing 20 tons per day, the shop waste. He is buying it. He is paying 2.35 rupees through a logistic manager. The entire waste comes into this factory. He is able to turn out 1/3 of Chennai's production of waste. Chennai produces 60 tons per day. He is processing 20 tons per day. See, you can clean it into this way. It's a cooker system, nothing but just a boiler where you go for a temperature and make it into a powder of meat meal, reuse it back to the industry. He is the Mr. Gentleman there. Biogas production, and he has got an innovative handling of, you know, smell. It was a big problem of exhaust. He put it into the water. So all the water gets absorbed, the smell gets absorbed in the water. That water is distributed to the green area. He has got 1 acre plant, 9 acres green he has done in Chennai. And last one, not the least, we have only one earth to take care. So what is the factor for that? Sustainability factors in poultry. We have to take care about land, we have to take care about water, we have to take care about grains, energy, environment, and the consumer preferences are totally changing. Do you know every consumer is tracked? Your buying behavior is tracked. Whatever you do in your restaurant, whatever you do in your big bazaar is tracked. Your behavior is mapped. Before you go into a shop, they'll tell you, sir, last time you bought this, would you like to have it? So that is the era now. The mantra is, more from less is the mantra. Great opportunity in India, 650 million people, young and energetic, 25 to 35, lots of value. Let's hope that encourage automation, incentivize farmers, recommend rainwater harvesting. Let poultry companies have exclusive agri division so that they can have their own corn, their own soya. Please think of that line. And great opportunity from our sector, free range or organic farming, rural poultry for the future. Let's hope that. And this is the app of our institution, CPDOTI app. You can download it in Google Play Store. You can link it to training, production, anything. Thank you very much for the attention. Thank you very much.